scatters when you play the beat, play the beat. A brainiac effect sound.
Now press rewind. Welcome to Brain Squeeze Reactions, myself, Mark Hector. What are we reacting to now? Tupac and Spice One. Tupac and Spice One. Okay, I fucking love when Spice One is talking about Tupac Shakur. And I did a reaction on Sunday, and a load of you messaged me and said, Hector, there's loads and loads of parts to this, and you sent over a couple for me to react. So I'm going to try and do these over the next couple of weeks, because you know my love for Spice One when he's talking about Tupac Shakur. I love the way that he brings emotions to life, but also just that, I don't know, just that fun side of Spice One and how he delivers it, the honesty as well. I just love the dude. I think he's genuine as fuck. Okay, you can't not like this dude. You just can't. And the one that I'm reacting to now is Spice One goes off on people calling Tupac a fake thug. He blasted two cops for jumping on, I'm guessing that's going to say a black man, because that's the whole piece of what Tupac did. Who is calling Tupac a fake thug? Who's doing that? Okay, is that T-Pain again? Probably. It wouldn't freaking surprise me. Anyways, if you're new to this channel, this is what we do. It's a discussion. It's a dissection and a discussion. Sorry, a reaction and a discussion. So I'm going to pause and I'm going to talk about it, okay? If you can't deal with that, just go. Just leave. Comment section is for love. It's not for hate. Haters go fuck oneself. Let's freaking go. Woo.
How you feel about people that say out-of-pocket stuff about Tupac to go viral? Like, they'll say something like, Tupac, he was a fake thug, he was a gimmick, and they only say it for attention to go viral. Because they know anything they say negative about Tupac is going to go viral. How you feel about that, yo?
I mean, to say that Pac was a gimmick or all of that shit like that is, you know, you might as well say, I'm a gimmick too, you know? What the fuck? I was with the nigga. So what the fuck, you know what I'm saying? For a nigga to say, oh, this nigga was that, well, I was with him, so you saying I'm all that too? I'm a motherfucking ballerina, nigga. I'm all that. You get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Like, he's just calling himself a ballerina. I can see a bit of frustration coming out at this moment. His whole voice went up. Can I just say, though, he's got a tray just full of fucking ganj. That's what he's doing there. He's about to skin one up. I just think that just shows the character of this dude as well. Just not giving a fuck. If that ain't fucking thuggish behavior whilst being recorded in an interview, already you're winning, Spice One, mate. You ain't got to argue anymore.
You know, you might as well say, I'm a gimmick too, you know? What the fuck? I was with the nigga. So what the fuck, you know what I'm saying? For a nigga to say, oh, this nigga was that, well, I was with him, so you saying I'm all that too? I'm a motherfucking ballerina, nigga. I'm all that. You get the fuck out of here, nigga. Like, me and that nigga used to get down, fool. You know what I'm saying? That's my guy. So, I mean, it wasn't no fake shit going on, man, you know? The nigga mama was a Black Panther, man. The nigga was born in jail. And came out to be a superstar, movie star, rap, legendary rap artist. Like, for a motherfucker to talk shit about a nigga that was born in jail, it just make you look like a bitch ass nigga. You know, for any nigga to talk shit about a nigga that was born in jail,
big
like,
time.
You need to be slapped, nigga.
Oh, Spice One. How can you argue with anything he's just said there? He said his ma was a Black Panther, born in jail, come out to be the most biggest rap star ever. Ever. And you're calling him fake?
Talk shit about a nigga that was born in jail. Like, you need to be slapped, nigga.
Need to be slapped.
Not punched, not shot, but you need to be slapped like a bitch. For saying shit, nigga. These niggas be saying shit like that, you know? Any nigga who ever come out and say shit like that about a motherfucker who came from that, from the rose that grew from the concrete, nigga,
oh,
for real?
Chills.
Nigga, mama's Black Panther, you know what I'm saying? She got all them niggas out of jail with no lawyer. You know?
I don't know that backstory.
Of course she did drugs and shit. Now who the fuck, you know, everybody go through that shit. You know what I'm saying? But she came up out of that shit. You know what I mean? So, I mean, you know, For all the motherfuckers that ever talk shit about the nigga mama or him or any of that shit, man, you gotta realize what that nigga went through. He had to shoot two off-duty cops because they was he thought they was two niggas, two motherfuckers jumping a nigga. Mm. Say you was just getting jumped by two motherfuckers somewhere and a nigga came out the blue and shot them niggas. You gonna respect that nigga, period. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, everybody who said that, who talked that shit, they ain't got shot five times. They ain't shot two off-duty motherfucking po-po for doing some dumb shit. You know,
just that alone, shot five times and shooting two off-duty police officers that were beating up a black man for no reason. Just that alone, how can you say anything's fake about Tupac? What are you comparing him against? What exactly are you comparing him against? It's madness to even think that, let alone say it aloud. It proves the lack of listening and understanding about Tupac's journey. His whole life cycle, not just his music career. That is such a small part of a bigger picture that he was pulling together. Politically, culturally, what he was trying to do, bringing East Coast and West Coast together, you know, to create a community. You know, it wasn't just music. That's what people forget. This dude was pulling the weight of culture on his back. And on the other side, racial profiling, police, rape charges, getting attacked every 2 seconds, buff, plus delivering some of the greatest music you're ever going to listen to. Before he was 25. What? Who else are you looking at? Okay, I don't know all rappers, fair play. Point out the one that I've missed that's done that. Please, show me the one whose mum was a Black Panther. Show me the one who was shot five times. Just point them out. Point them out for me. I'll gladly wait. I'll wait here. Okay, you let me know. It's unbelievable,
they
man.
They talk that shit. They ain't got shot five times.
No, the fuck they didn't.
They ain't shot two off-duty motherfucking po-po for doing some dumb shit. Mm-mm. You know, so, you know, it's really just like, it's bullshit, man. You know what I'm saying? Like we, you know, I'm a, you know, we get down, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm just, motherfuckers are just lucky I'm rapping. You know what I'm saying? You know, and I was Pac homie, nigga. I'm a motherfucking rider, nigga. I'm one of his riders, nigga.
That just gave me chills. Is that like a Spice One warning discussion there? Is he saying I was thinking, what do you mean you're lucky I'm rapping? You're lucky I'm rapping. I'm a rider. I'm one of his boys, he's saying. Ah, I didn't even think about that.
You know, and I was Pac homie, nigga. I'm a motherfucking rider, nigga. I'm one of his riders, nigga. So I mean, for a nigga to say anything, and he one of my riders, nigga. Mm. We get down. So I mean, for a motherfucker to say anything, while I'm still walking around this motherfucker, they gonna have to answer to me because I was with the nigga.
That's giving me buzz vibes, man. Spice One, talk. Stevie Knight, talk your shit.
Still walking around this motherfucker, they gonna have to answer to me because I was with the nigga. So if a motherfucker say if he was all of this bullshit, nigga, get the fuck out of here. Shut the fuck up, nigga. Mm. I was there, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Just like I was there to watch Jordan play, nigga. Just like I was there to watch motherfucking Mike Tyson fight. I was there kicking it with Tupac, nigga. Mm. And I'm here to tell you, nigga, all that bullshit is bullshit. Any of you niggas need to lay that bullshit to rest. All that shit you got about, oh, Pac was this and he was that nigga and he wasn't that. Nigga, he was whatever the fuck he said he was in his goddamn songs, nigga, period. Mm. Whatever he said he was in his songs, that's what he was. Nothing more, nothing less, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you know, for what that's worth, hell no. Nah. All that bullshit niggas was talking, man, and that make shit that they making up, somebody made up. Mm. Man, motherfuckers make up shit about entertainers all the time. That shit don't be true. I heard I smoke crack. Somebody told me, oh, he used to smoke crack. I ain't never snorted a line, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Like, on some real shit. I can take my glasses off and tell you motherfuckers, nah, nigga, I ain't never snorted a motherfucking line. And if a nigga ever approached me like I snorted a line, he gonna be asleep, nigga, right there where he said that shit at. Oh, God.
Fuck, man. Spice One's gangster thug side is coming out hard. I can feel the frustration. You clearly need to fucking skin that one up quick. And if I was interviewing, I'd be like, fuck, Spice, I didn't fucking say it. I wasn't saying it, bro. I'm just asking a question. Fuck, I love this dude, man. I genuinely love Spice One, man. I need to listen to more of his music. He's just a legend.
I snorted a line, he gonna be asleep, nigga, right there where he standing.
Damn straight he is.
Oh, God.
You ain't gonna say on God,
so,
I believe you.
You know, a lot of motherfuckers talk shit and make shit up about entertainers, my nigga. So, you know, you gotta sit back and think about it sometime. You know, you'll get a little taste of the fame, you know. You'll get a little taste of that shit. Niggas gonna, you know, you get a little anything, motherfuckers gonna start making up shit about you and talking about you. We all done had a taste of that shit.
Fuck, I've had that on this channel, and I've barely even started. I did the, what is the tune I did? And it was on fuck me, it was on the Super Bowl, the Tupac one. And then I did a reaction, and some dude said, ah, I've got ya, you're fake, you're this, you're that, you're this, you're that, because you said about this track. But I was like, I said I know this track. I didn't say I didn't know it. You didn't listen, you fucking idiot. I said I don't listen to the lyrics. I hadn't listened to the lyrics. But I knew the fucking song because I said it on the Super Bowl. But bang, 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 bang. Fake. You're fake. You're this. You're that. You're this. You're that. Fuck you, man. And that's what this dude's saying. You get a taste of it. You get a taste of it. And other people are there to try and pull you the fuck down based on their own standards. Based on how they do stuff. Even now you're judging me for speaking. Fuck you. If you're the one judging me right now, fuck you. Okay? I'm being me. Who the fuck are you judging? Of what standard? As Bill Burr said, what the fuck you do? Levitating above all of us? Yes, Spice One, man. Legend.
Fuckers gonna start making up shit about you and talking about you. We all done had a taste of that shit. But when it comes to the point to where a motherfucker is selling millions of copies, you gotta respect the magnitude of that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The magnitude of that shit goes up 100%. The haters be real. Motherfuckers make up shit and say the nigga did this and did that and shit, and you be sitting up there like, what the fuck? Like, hell no, that shit didn't happen. Motherfucker, I heard I got beat up or something. I heard all kind of old shit. And you be sitting there like, man, what the fuck this nigga talking about? Like, I've been sitting right here the whole time. Like, so, I mean, you know, yeah, they just need to dead that shit and respect the nigga music and respect it, what a motherfucker doing to push forward. You know, he tried to push the black race forward. He tried to push hip-hop forward. You know what I'm saying? In a strong way, he tried to make motherfuckers be soldiers. You know? Nip tried to make motherfuckers get money. You know what I'm saying?
Nipsey.
It's the respect level of that shit need to go up, you know, when it comes to shit like that. You know what I'm saying? You can't just talk shit about a nigga who was helping everybody out when he was alive and shit. Don't make no motherfucking sense. Anybody say some shit, I'm telling all my niggas right now. All my niggas watching this interview, if you my nigga, if these niggas start talking shit about me, nigga, when I'm gone, blow their motherfucking brains out. Fuck these niggas.
Oh, fuck.
Talk.
Ah, shit. Oh, Spice, man. Oh, fuck. And then the bottle popped.
Damn. All my niggas watching this interview, if you my nigga, if these niggas start talking shit about me, nigga, when I'm gone, blow their motherfucking brains out. Fuck these niggas.
Whew.
Talking that punk ass shit. You know what I'm saying? Respect us, nigga.
Damn straight.
You know what I'm saying? Don't tell them when I'ma go. But respect mine, nigga, straight the fuck up. And like I say, give me my motherfucking flowers and roses now, because I ain't gonna see that shit when I'm dead. I ain't gonna see the love when I'm gone. You know what I'm saying? I need to see this shit now. Go buy my records now. Come to my shows now. You know what I'm saying? Same shit. So I mean, you know, it's all a respect level. You know, I done met motherfuckers that I never seen before. Tell me they was raised off my music. I got songs older than half the motherfuckers watching this interview. You know what I'm saying? So I mean, you know, I come from a long line of poets. I do this shit without even trying. I don't even write no more. I just spit real shit. So I mean, you know, when it come to that, you know, I feel like I gotta give my audience something that they can't do. Mm. And we always doing that. From Pac to Biggie to every other motherfucker that was really spitting. So I mean, it's all about a respect level for, you gotta respect the motherfucker who doing that. Motherfucking roses that come from the concrete. I came from some fucking projects, nigga. They was called the Pink Palace, and I lived in Frisco in the Pink Palace with some pissy elevators and rats and roaches and all kind of shit. I came up from that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I came from Frisco to Oakland to Haywood, you know what I'm saying? So I mean, you know, everybody that had they taste of poverty, you know, every nigga that had his taste of poverty, especially if he done rose up out the motherfucking shit and he talking now, and then, you know, when he died, motherfuckers got something bad to say. Mm. Like, nigga, what? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, my motherfuckers got something to say about everybody. Motherfuckers talk shit about Huey Newton. They talk shit about Malcolm X, you know? These is motherfuckers who did something, you know, that changed the system or changed the way that a nigga think. And then you got a motherfucker that's going to come out the blue and talk shit. Man, slap that nigga, dude. Straight the fuck up. Real shit.
Fucking hell, man. I mean, Spice One. At the end, I was just absorbing what he was saying, just absorbing it, because you could see there was an air of frustration, but just delivering his preach, man. And rightly so. I'm not saying it's a preach as a negative. I'm saying it as a massive positive. Everything he was saying was correct. Everything he was saying there, and I could feel his frustration. But that bit where he said, if they talk about me like this when I'm gone, blow their motherfucking brains out. That to me speaks volumes of who Spice One is. Now, if I'm one of these people that was, and thank fuck I'm more educated than that, and spent a solid 7 months educating on this, culturally as well as Tupac's music. But if I was one of those people that was talking absolute horse shittery about Tupac Shakur, and I watched this, that there's a couple of moments in there, that's hit 'em up shit going on there, where you go, okay, I'm just gonna fucking just step back a bit. If you don't, refer back to what Spice One said, and I'm just saying, on your head be it, 'cause fuck that.